we on? We're on, I guess, right? I'd like to welcome you to the second annual Alarmit Distributors Picnic here somewhere in God's country off of Hartford Road. This is AVS video production, all union scale, $27 every 15 minutes. I just got drowned out by the music there. I guess everything's all right. We'll see if we get some action going here today. And a couple minutes, we'll try to turn it over to Mr. Spangler.
French lessons and more. A vacation and a half that won't cost you a price and a half. Since a week at practically any Club Med Village this summer costs $900.
Got the lineup here.
Okay. Okay, we're on. I'll turn this over to.
Are Bill. We live?
No, we're live with Bill Spangler of Alarmit Distributors, 7700 Hartford Road, right?
All right, this is my first experience live. I'd like to introduce myself as Bill Spangler from Alarmit. This evening we're having a nice picnic, inviting all our local installers. I'd like to thank everybody for coming here, especially Emmett for doing this video spot for us. I don't know how well I'm doing here, but I'd like to thank everybody. Thank goodness it's a nice day. We're gonna have a good game here. We're gonna have the A team versus the B team. And we should be starting this game within 15 minutes. How's that? Thanks everybody. See y'all later. Oh, was that supposed to be on that one?
TV here.
Joe, come on, Marty, come on.
This is high class now, come on.
Is the mayor going to throw out the ball?
We're on
live, okay. We're live, get up here in the field, quick.
Did you say quick?
Get up here, get in the line.
Did I hear you say quick?
Get behind.
Live via satellite.
Get behind Aaron. Get behind Aaron.
Oh, I'm on TV.
Come on,
get
Bob. Get behind Aaron. Oh, Joe Buck. God darn you, Joe. All right, we're going to forget Joe Buck.
Joe's hugging the kid, come on.
Okay, here we go.
You got me, I Joe.
Hello there, I'm Bill Spangler, representing A-Team's captain. I represent Alarmit Distributors. Next.
Hey, John, don't ruin the film.
Hey, Tim, back at Automatic Security System, shortstop, all right.
Hey, what position am I? What position?
I'm Dave Massarelli up here to play some baseball.
I forgot my company. Would you put that in?
Pagnowski, installation form and crime deterrent system.
Rick Grise of the Key Shop.
Mark Appleby, professional softball player, filling in part-time for General Alarm Company.
I'm Joe Bugs, Independent Brewers Association.
I'm Aaron Ball, and I represent Protection Plus. Howard Beard, Protection Plus, right tackle.
I'm a free agent and a freeloader, and I demand a 50,000-year contract for 10 years.
God, come on, you ain't running from traffic. Get off the microphone.
Jennifer. Rob Farmer with Total Security Alarm Company playing catcher.
This is Barty on the A-Team, Alarmant Distributors number one.
Jennifer Gries from Keisha.
Okay, here's the batting order. Here's the batting order. Okay, now you gotta go for the batting order. Okay, put the seat like that.
We've got somebody doing the play-by-play. This is Joe Bucks here with Emmett Toomey. Doing the play-by-play, Bill Spangler, Alarmant Distributors at bat. And the first pitch is lined out to the fence. That's a base hit. Second batter is Tim Paquette, playing shortstop. And the pitch is lined out there in right field for left field for a base hit. Bill Spangler moving to third base. He's safe at third as Price fumbles the ball. David Massarelli, third batter here. And the pitch is low and hitting the plate. Delivery from Gulumbeck. Steve Reich swinging a miss. The music goes down and the fervor gets loud and it's outside. Oh, that looked good. Nice swing from Massarelli. Massarelli hits, it's a fair ball. It's a fair ball. Down the line, here comes two runs in, 2-0. Massarelli's in standing with a double. Pat Itchum's up. Hey Bill, what's Rick's last name? Huh? Your last name on Rick.
Stunning.
Pat Ignowski.
Pat Ignowski.
Oh, the Ignowski. Polish pride's up. Here comes the Polish pride, Pat Ignowski. First pitch, swung on and missed, and he threw the bat. My God, I hope the fans are okay. Excuse the guy, he's Polish. I'm doing the play-by-play.
Pat, then Rick.
Ignowski. Second pitch to him. He swings and lines a shot to the shortstop. It's caught. He's safe at second. Here comes Rick of Overly Key. You can tell by all the keys hanging from his pants. That's Overly Key. They cut keys, foul ball. Galumbeck's ready to deliver. Men on second base. Oh, it was a good pitch, but that's a goodbye. Mark Appleby's on deck. Oh, there's a line shot back to the pitcher. Oh, he's going to run him down. Back to Price. He's out at third. Mark Appleby. $2 is on deck. Who's going to do the play-by-play?
I'm on deck.
Guy, come here. Guy Beck. Another good man will do the play-by-play. I'm on deck. Mark Appleby. Mark Appleby here.
Mark is a former veteran of the USFL. It's a pop ball. He's running in. It's caught. That's the inning, folks. Who do I know?
Let's see what happens. Everybody take a
place.
Where's the list? Where's the paper?
We're going in that order, right?
As long as everybody's names on the list. Here's that list.
Clyde Meadows from Central Security.
Come on, man. Light him up. Let's go. Tell me.
Steve Heyer from Alarmant.
Brian Glumbeck, Alarmant.
Caesar Alarmant.
Mike Water.
Doug Geiser.
Number four.
Take it easy.
That was Joe Bucks. He just popped up to middle outfield.
Okay, Brian. Okay, John.
John Bucks, my suck-ass brother, swings and misses. Taco John takes one outside. On deck is Howard Beard. And you know why if you look at him.
Howard the Beard Howard.
Oh, there's a foul tip. Golumbek doing a hell of a job.
We got a player down in the field.
Can we do a spot interview with some of the team members?
Sure can, sure can. Who would you like to do a spot interview with? Back off.
Some of John hits are like fun.
There's a ground ball. Oh, he overthrows it. And he'll take second base when he overthrow.
You've been professionally announced for ball games for the past 2 or 3 years at least.
26 and a half to be exact.
What do you feel of the teams that we have in front?
Well, they're evenly matched. We got the Sweat Hogs against the Mud Lovers. And I'll be honest with you, I think the Mud Lovers have an advantage in the sun.
Well, I understand the Mud Lovers have a 3-0 record, and I'm not sure how good the Sweat Hogs are. Do you know anything of the Sweat Hogs?
Well, the Sweat Hogs have played 26 games and lost 29 of them.
Well, the last
But they're a formidable opponent for the Mud Lovers. There goes a shot by Howard Beard. Oh, it's caught by the left fielder. Next, we have Howard's little son, Aaron. No relation to Hank. He's a Beard, too. Huh? Aaron. Marty Bowen on deck. No, Rob's after him. Oh, he tried. No bunting allowed in this league. Who told this guy to bunt? He bunts.
Go,
it's a fair ball. Play by Glumbeck to throw to first. He's safe. It's an overthrow. Hey, that's in fair territory. Go to third.
And Aaron makes it home on a throwaway
bunt.
Ball.
That just goes to show you the offensive power that the Mud Lovers have.
Well, you can see in professional softball that we have real good opponents here today.
Yes, well,
the sun is hot.
The Sweat Hogs are a good team. Like I said, they've lost 29 out of 26. That was a hit, nice grab by the center fielder, but it's going to go in for a single. Rob. Here's Rob up. He was introduced to you earlier in the day.
Okay, I've been waiting for your brother. He stepped right in front of me and I was running full force. I couldn't stop.
Here comes Rob. Glumbeck letting in two more runs. Looks worried. Throws it inside on the corner. Waiting for his pitch. He pops it up. Short outfielder, shortstop Steve Heyer. He has the play. And that's the final out of the inning. With the score, the Mud Lovers 4 and the Sweat Hogs 1.
Stop that, okay? So it's Caesar, then it's me, then it's Joe.
What about Mike?
I'm Mike.
Mike Doppelbeck.
7th made last out.
Okay. So it's Caesar.
It's 8. Number 8's up.
Okay. Well, what is the score? 4-1?
Will's quick, so I guess I'm wrong.
4-1? Okay, we got Caesar up. Will dropped out. Okay, we got Mike Appleby up after Caesar Ciccanti. Score is 4-1 inside. Oh, he took a nice hit on that one. He dropped it. All right, it's a base hit. All right, now we got Mike Offerby up. Let's see what this man can do. Oh man, he's got that Murray stance. Yeah. Check this guy out, man. He's playing all taking over top of the trees. Oh, he pops it up. First baseman. Oh, he tags him out. Okay. So now we got Joe Pone. Okay, we got Joe's up now. We got Tom, Sue, and Kim. Oh, it picks up some dirt. Oh, outside. Ground ball, third baseman, foul.
Talking to?
Huh?
Talking to?
Yeah. be communicating with that guy when we want to shut it off and turn to another thing, turn to that camera. It's a fly ball. It chops in this left center. All right. Got a man on second and first and second, not a mistake. Tom Price, next batter up. Oh, swing and a miss. Oh, foul tip. One. 4-1. Yep. Fly ball, well hit, well hit. Is he gonna get it? Oh, don't like to catch. Sue's up next. There you go.
Who's up?
Go, move. What's the last out?
No. Yeah.
Who's cutting?
No, I guess it's the
I'm mine. No.
Here we go. It's the top of the third inning.
Hey, what's the score, guys?
Score 4-1 in favor of the Mud Lovers. Guy Beck batting for the love of the Mud Lovers.
Guy Jennifer in the top of the order.
You're best. Fifth in the inning. You do fifth in the inning.
Guy Beck batting. Trying to. Yeah, guy's a poor farm boy from Towson. Lives up on a big hill. And he grows marijuana plants. Just kidding. It's cocaine. Goodlum, Beck gets ready for delivery. Oh, it's way inside. Beck returns it to him. There's a high pop-up. Looks like the second baseman has it. He's under it and makes the play.
Here comes a couple sorry-looking dudes.
Now grab a team and join. The team batting is running 4-1 in the top of the third. Yeah.
Sometimes 20 people
are. Yeah. Start a volleyball game then.
Play by play here.
Sure am. Now Jennifer's up. And here's my fine assistant, Mark Applebaum.
Now, professionally speaking, two organized ball clubs of such vast knowledge and players' actions, they're doing a fine job in the sun today. Temperatures must be sweltering 90 degrees, and the sweat is just pouring off their foreheads. I can see it off my folks? Assistants here. And up at bat,
and
we have.
Out here.
Who do we have at bat?
We have Jennifer at bat.
and Jennifer makes a out at first.
Out to the shortstop, no problem. The first.
And two Jennifer outs. Will be followed by
Bill Spangler.
Bill Spangler of representing Alarm Shit Delivers Distributors.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Alarm It.
From England. They're a nationally known company. They're being represented well today at this picnic here at Grand Memorial Park.
There's a guy back. He made the first half. Say something about the first half guy.
That was a breaking ball, a real mean breaking ball.
You heard it, folks, from the batter himself. First pitch to Spangler is foul ball, third base side. That's Mark. That's Scott. Sometimes they wonder if your stepson's he may be girl tomorrow. Spangler hits another ground ball, third base. Price bobbles. Price makes a throw to first. He's safe, and it's an overthrow at first base. Tim Paquette is up. He's the first baseman on his team. Batting 341 this year for the Mud Lovers. Two down.
I don't want to mention, folks, we have a fine camera crew today.
Emmett Toomey there.
And he is representing AVS, and AVS is doing a fine job at this outing today.
Pitch from Glumbeck. It's high.
To the right side.
That was a plate, man. I called you. Oh, shit, I'm sorry. Well, I pulled the foam off the mic and all.
You buzz that off there.
Got a beep, beep, beep it.
Oh, there's a high pop-up. Price at third base. He calls me. Price makes the play. And that's the final out of the inning. At the end of 2 1/2 innings, the score is the Mud Lovers 4, the Sweat Hogs 1.
And we're going to pause for station identification.
Okay, let's get ahead.
4-1 beaten.
David Massarelli leading off for the Mud Lovers. The Mud Lovers have done well on this dry surface. Hey, this bud's for me. I love it. Comes my assistant, Mark Applebaum.
And it's a fine
speaking
ball,
to the mic.
Just speaking to the mic, he pulls it down by his.
We're on TV.
Okay. Is the intermission over yet?
No, we're live. No, we're live.
Oh, I didn't see the red light lit.
But you're running a commercial.
Okay.
Right? For okay. Diet Coke. Diet Coke's a sponsor, you asshole.
7-Up.
Diet Coke is a sponsor, you asshole. They changed.
How about?
Giving us more money, man. It's Diet
Coke. Okay. Now replacing Aaron and batting for Aaron is Paul Golombek.
Paul Golombek.
Number 42.
Is now replacing Aaron Mustache. Massarelli demands that the plate should be cleaned. Batting for Howard Beard.
John Thompson from Virginia Tech.
No, they suck, man. We ain't putting nobody from Virginia Tech on our team. No, no, no.
We got two people from Virginia Tech.
Unless they're black,
you're blocking
forget
our camera,
it.
Please.
Just okay. Because they beat Memphis State, them guys think they're good.
We have a batter up. We're waiting now for a catcher.
Massarelli's up.
Come on, ball's in the pitcher's hand.
Hey.
It's pretty wild, isn't it?
First baseman.
The catcher is a real sweat hog. If you just look at him, focus that on the catcher once, Emmett. He's a real sweat hog.
He's focusing on you, Joe.
But I'm on the Mud Lovers.
There you go. Pack at his first baseman. Ball's hit into play.
All right.
For the 18.
And he is safe at first.
Paquette leaves. He has to go. Meantime, Master Roy's at first. Pat the Pollock's up.
He heard that.
The Pollock's easier to say than whatever your last name is. The pitch, it's outside, but he hits it anyway to the pitcher. There's no play, second to play, first and then retiring. Rick's up. Rick. Where's Rick? Where's Rick? I think overly key. Oh, look who just showed up. Boo, boo.
And on deck will be
Applebee's on deck.
Is that the famous Mark?
Yeah, Mark Applebaum.
Oh, Applebaum, yeah.
He speaks into the mic. Gives good red.
Mark Applebaum.
Meantime, overly key. Oh, he takes one low.
Is that on all the time?
Oh, yeah.
Yes. What would you like an interview?
How long have you been sports announcer?
This is Rob.
About 2 minutes.
2 minutes? Well, that's good enough. Come on over here and talk to the mic.
Pitch from Golombek. It's a ground ball. It's chopped. Price picks it up. Price bobbles it. Price can't handle third, and there's no play at first. Oh, he makes a play at first, but it's a Massarelli scores, making it 5-1 to Mud Lovers. And
what do you think?
Rick goes to second.
This is a heck of a ball game here, isn't it?
Well, if you're a Mud Lover fan, Joe Bucks is on deck. I'm going to have to go now.
Is it Joe Buckstein?
No.
Okay, he's on deck.
The batter up is Mark Applebaum. Batter on deck is Joe Buckstein. Swing. It's a nice hit. Nice pop up. It's caught. Out of there. Oh, man. Three outs.
Did you go after us or we think?
Hey!
Hitting the ball down off my glove to the brother John who made the put out.
Oh, quit on that shit. Who's shirt? Mine.
Mine's the one that's happening to Jenny. Yeah. We're going seven, right?
Oh, no! I meant to wear, not to wipe the sweat off.
Oh, if I wear it, it's going to be worse. If I wear it, it's going to be toast, but now I just want to wipe it out my eyes. Burn it, man.
No, I'm
going down. Big Joe Buckstein. Buckstein. That's Joe Buckstein. He's up. That's live.
Go where, did you say?
Now up, Mr. Joe Buckstein. An incredible hitter. He plays third base.
What's your name?
My name is Paul.
Paul?
Where's Joe on here?
He's on there. Buckstein. Joe Buckstein, good average.
Joe Bucks.
Joe Buck?
Buckstein.
Joe Buck weighs in at 420.
Now batting, Joe Buckstein.
Paul, listen now. What do you think of the bat of Joe Buckstein?
I think he's an incredible, imposing figure. He's very imposing.
Yeah, I agree.
I wouldn't want to run into him.
Look at that hit by Joe Buckstein.
Oh, it's off the glove of Steve Heyer. Let's start it first. Joe, it's overthrown. It's overthrown. He's going for second.
The crowd, Ryan.
So, incredible.
Yeah. Joe. Popcorn, peanuts.
Get your watermelon here.
His twin brother, John Buckstein, used car buyer, trader in used cars, John Bucks.
Joe B. Joe Buckstein on second base there, looking up the eye.
Batter up his brother, John Buckstein.
Waiting for the pitcher here. Pitcher winds up. It's a pitch. Oh, foul ball to the right.
Foul ball. That's a ball.
Foul ball.
Oh, yes, folks. Have you heard the latest with John Bucks and Don Carney Crabhouse?
This is John Buckstein, the famous Joe's brother. He's known for the cologne he wears, John Buckstein.
They pass that nose blow.
Hey, Mark, need a sports announcer here.
All right. Joe Buckstein's coming home. Joe Buckstein's got it. That's Joe and John Buckstein up at bat right now. This is Mark Applebaum, famous sports writer.
Who's up?
And who was just at the last bat?
Who just batted?
John just got up.
John batted
John
last.
Buckstein, yeah, famous Joe's brother.
Howard Beard is now on deck. Where is Howard?
Yeah.
Howard appears. Howard appears to be absent.
Howard Arrow.
At this present
Aaron.
Time. And Paul will be batting for Howard. And Paul is now on deck, moving to the plate. And there's a pitch, and it's a high ball into left field. Foul ball. There's a pitch. Pop ball to Steve. Steve throws it to home. And no good. And another run scored. That will be John Bucks that came in on that run. And we have Marty batting. Ball in the left field. And Marty rounding the second, and he is safe. There's a pitch. No good. And a wild pitch. I believe they're trying to walk him. This is Rob up at bat. And we have with us now Bill Spangler from Alarmant Distributors. Bill, would you like to say a few words?
Looks like a good hit. Look at that. One of the best hits of the game.
Yes. That
but
was
an
Rob.
Error. But an error.
Rob.
Here he comes. Here comes Marty. Look at this.
And Marty is in for
Stand
another run.
Up. Sport. Oh, looking good.
Well, what's that bring
what
our
inning
score
is this?
To?
What inning is this?
This would be the
another one come in.
Another
one. Me. Come party shirt.
Oh, God.
I threw it at the guy. I said, God, get up on your shirt.
Wipe your face off.
Man, you could've worked.
How's that? Is that all right?
We stand too close.
So you got to turn it. This will be Guy batting, and we are in the what inning?
I think
see,
it's the third.
I knew I caught you by surprise.
I think it's the third there, Mark.
This should be the fifth inning.
Okay. Good eye by Guy. It's good eye by Guy.
And every ball player today is definitely feeling the heat as they're sweating. Most of them playing with that shirt. Ball is fouled.
I think they hit her in the head, man. I thought I was going to hit her in the head. Guy still up with that.
I seem to be missing my primary sportscaster for the day. He's taking a slight leave.
Hey, Joe!
With him, he took the record, so I'm not sure if we're in the fifth inning or not, and I'm not
Joe,
also sure
you?
What the score is at this time.
Joe Buckstein! What inning? Come here!
First baseman is caught.
Path is right.
Joe, with you, since you have walked left, there have been two runs in, and now two out.
Hey.
And we're not sure what inning we're in, nor are we sure what
we're in the top of the fifth. If we score two runs, including mine, that makes it 6-1.
6-1?
Yes. Oh, the Mud Lovers, that's us.
And the Mud Lovers leaving. Scored 6-1, the top of the fifth
seven
inning.
7 now.
Ron just scored.
And Ron coming
7-1, the Mud Lovers.
For the Mud Lovers.
Whoa, his feet. Feeling alone.
If you walk back and watch this.
The arm is overgrown. Salvation a la mode with a cup of tea. Yeah.
And I'm sorry, but you start yeah, away
and easy.
And
Tim Puckett, and she's coming home for 9.
Jennifer in. That will be
8-1.
8-1 for the Mud Lovers. Bringing Bill around to third.
Got Bill's on third base, and he's going to steal the plate. And John Bux is up now. He is a sorry Nate. Dave's up. Dave's up. And David,
Tim Pack quit, isn't it?
Now he quit.
Mozzarella.
Now them Italians are, man. They can't, I know it.
Are you guys loaded? Just tell me, man. Am I the only one loaded here?
Yeah, we're all pretty bummed.
None of us are loaded today.
I'm not.
They all keep telling me they're all straight over there, and I'm all fucked.
They might be.
Not one, Mike. Keep that out of there, please.
Hey, Mozzarella, Price for the third. They got him in third.
That makes your final out. And we will be moving
the end of
the
4-1 day. Half. No, it's 5-5.
That's 5. No, it isn't.
Yeah, they bet.
That's right. That was it. That's right. That was the top.
Here.
8-1.
56,
something like that.
Somewhere around that area. You're up next. That's Caesar and me.
Who's the other dog?
Okay, 18 players, let's go!
Hey, Sean!
Come on! Talk about my ball, man!
Pat's up, I think.
How long is this going on, Joe? I'm gonna head out for a little while.
For Bart.
For Bart. I'm gonna try and make it back. Check you out later.
All right, take it easy, man.
And now rejoining my fellow sportscaster, Joe Bucks.
I am Joe.
And we are at the top of the sixth inning. Pat is batting on deck. I didn't hear you. Ignowski. Pat Ignowski. Pat has a 3-0 record. Foul ball. Ball is hit, fair ball, left center field, and brings Pat on to second base. Rick on deck, moving into the batter's box. This will be Rick's first RBI of the season, if he can bring Pat in. Hit shortstop, and the play is made at first. Please stand by for a technical difficulty as we have lost sound due to lack of announcers.
Now up. Mark Applebaum. He's got revenge in his eyes. The first ball is wide outside. Wide outside again. When will he get him across? Applebaum's warming up. He's going crazy. It bounces on the plate. Three balls. Applebaum fouls one off, back to the catcher. Another foul off, back to the catcher. Counts 3-2. What will happen? What will happen? Applebaum pops one up. It's to the shortstop. He drops it. Applebaum heads way. Run, Mark! Mark!
Never saw it come out of his glove.
Yeah, I was like, I thought Mark, he still had what's it. He doing, man? Keep running.
I thought he still had it.
That was incredible throws. Yeah. Throw it from the outfield. Joe Bux is out.
It's the bottom of the sixth inning.
That leaves a score as we're moving into the bottom of the sixth inning at 8-1. But lovers are leaving it.
Who made the last out?
Who made the last out?
Thank you.
Bill. I like that self-confidence. I like that.
How many men we got? Okay, I got it.
Okay, play ball. We need a catcher for you guys. Ready? Everybody ready?
Okay.
What do you mean you need a catcher? Look at all the guys you got. You got a lot of guys.
This guy's got 15 players. Come back here. Hey! Hey!
Woke me up from my nap.
They're gonna have a rally this
Get
it on the ground.
Second.
Hey, Bill. Fly up.
And then Niska Lambeck is up. She's looking for a nice. Oh, buck! 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 Takes it for a ball. Here comes Bill. Got the wind up. Here comes. Foul ball. They've lost a lot of players. Their players are not enduring enough to play this game.
Let's go, let's go.
Here comes Denise. Oh, it takes for another ball. Oh, ball. She wants a good pitcher! Fouls it back. Hey, Bill!
We're lucky, that's all. Luck. Luck. Uh-oh, new
Bob's up.
And we're moving into the top of the seventh inning here with the Sweat Hogs trailing by 3. Mud Lovers leading it 8-5. John, and that'll bring John Bucks up the bat. The Mud Lovers leading it 8-5. And we have a batter up. This has been one fantastic ball game, folks, right here at Grand Memorial Field. Incidentally, the proceeds of this game will go to the Handicapped Alarm Installers Association. Seems to be a little confusion on the field. I can't make what it is yet.
We lost Marty.
There's a pitch. Oh. And the ball is hit out into left field. And that puts John on first base. Bringing up the bat, Paul. Paul from Virginia Tech. He's a fine sportsman. Played ball all his life. There's a pitch. High out in the left field. Bringing Paul around to first. And he falls, but he makes it to second. That was a fair ball. That was fair. Must be losing my judgment, or they're drunker than I am. Outside. Swing and a miss. It's a high pop up. Caught by third baseman. And that'll be the first out of the inning. It brings Marty up to bat. Correction, the batting order has been changed. That will be Rob. Ball's hit high. Caught again by the third baseman for the second out of the inning. And the score is 8-5. Mud Lovers leading it by 3. Bill Spangler up the bat. And it's a high fly out in the left field, caught by Steve for the final out as we move into the bottom of the seventh inning. The score 8-5.
Let's count the one. five got the last out, right?
Look out!
Oh, man, I'm blessed.
the headset on. This is Emmett Toomey with AVS Video Productions. It seems as the sun goes down on this picnic, June 11th, 1983, Alignment Distributor's second annual picnic. It looks like everybody's had a good time. Some people look like they've had a super time. It looks like 50 of the 275 people that attended are totally drunk and passed out by many trees. The beer's gone, the sun's going down, and I guess we'll bid you farewell from the picnic grounds here in Cub Hill.
Never really big. That's something to copy. battery was up. He
literally had to play his guitar upside down, but when he did with it, it was a whole different story.
Say a farewell to his battery.
Jimi Hendrix experience on
say a farewell. We got to get some more people in here to say a farewell. Denise, come here.
This thing's not on, is it?
Sure is.
Oh, good. Excuse me while I kiss this guy.
Put it on. I'm going to put it on.